We want to go to the other two. Felix talked about one particular hotspot that's on the PG&E list. There are two others on the Central Coast, in Salinas and in Monterey, that actually rank even higher on the list. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong continues our team coverage live in Salinas.
Aaron, those two places come in on the list at 39 and even higher than that at number 5 in this list of 100 in the entire state. And at number 5 is in Monterey, in a suburban area of Monterey, near Highway 68 at Aguajito Road. PG&E is looking at about 430 feet of pipe there, saying there are multiple factors into why it's a high priority area, but they are not specified. At number 39 is in Salinas, near Highway 101 across from Hartnell Road. PG&E is concerned about a 1,320 feet of pipe in the rural area there because of potential for third-party damage. And as Jeff Smith had said before, that really refers to construction most of the time. So it's concerns of digging deep enough to hit the pipeline segment. Now, the San Bruno pipeline that exploded was actually not on this list. In a press conference today, PG&E President Chris Johns said the list is just one of the ways to ensure public safety with the 20,000 pipeline segments in the state.
So part of our normal operating procedures is to constantly evaluate all of our pipelines in all of these segments. And this consists of routine maintenance, leak surveys that we do, inspections of the pipelines, and 24-hour monitoring of the entire system.
PG&E is mostly monitoring the pipeline segments in the top 100 list, but there are four other stages. Initiated is the second one. That's where the Monterey site stands, meaning that it needs more analysis and study. At the third stage, engineers are defining the scope of a project to fix that segment, and that's the stage the San Juan Bautista site is currently in. Before, of course, it goes into construction, and then when the project is finally complete and moved off the list. And there's no status we want to mention for that Salinas site, so we'll look into that. But typically, though, where there is concern of third-party damage, which is the Salinas site, and concerns of construction, PG&E engineers will visit the site and they'll put up special signs and markings to let people know where the pipeline is and to avoid digging in that area. Aaron.
All right, Stephanie, thank you. And if you're a PG&E customer, here's the hotline that I promised. You can call a free hotline number and find out if you live near a high-pressure gas transmission line. That number is 888-743-7431. So 888-743-7431. You can find out if you live within 500 feet of one of the utility company's top 100 lines considered high risk. Also, log on to our website, ksbw.com, where you will find a map detailing the exact locations of the three Central Coast pipelines, the entire list of the high risk locations in the state. And if you didn't get that toll-free number down, you'll find it on the top story section of our website. It's all right there at ksbw.com.